So now let's watch a documentary on Hazrat Mirza Nasir Ahmed, the third Khalifa of the Promised Messiah.
A father and son were once traveling on a boat with a few friends. The son exclaimed, "How nice would it be had we now had some fish?" His father replied that it is very possible that our God sends us a fish from this very river. In hearing this, a friend said that the boy is too young to understand such matters. But without hesitation, the father answered that our God is all-powerful, and if he so willed, would send us a fish this very instant. Lo and behold, before he had even finished his sentence, a big wave swept up a large fish onto the deck of the boat. In many ways, this prodigious child was the fulfillment of the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's prophecy regarding the promised Messiah Alayhi Salam, that he would marry and have offspring. His name was Hazrat Mirza Nasir Ahmed.
Khuda ka ye ehsaan hai hum pe bhari ke jisne hai apni ye ne'mat utari.
He was born on the 16th of November 1909 in Qadian. At the tender age of 13, he had completed the memorization of the Holy Quran, and by the age of 20, he was among the top students to achieve the Maulvi Fadhil degree. He was sent to England on the 6th of September 1934, where, having studied in Oxford University, completed his BA and MA in philosophy and economics. During his time as a student in England, Hazrat Mirza Nasir Ahmed started a monthly magazine entitled Al-Islam, with the sole purpose of showing the Western world the true, beautiful teachings of Islam. He states, "Many a time I would wonder why my father gave me permission and spent so much money for me to go and study in Oxford University. It was not that I come and learn something from them, but that I myself become worthy enough to one day come and teach them. This is why I observed and examined the way they live and behave." On the 8th of November, 1965, after the sad demise of his father, Hazrat Mirza Nasir Ahmed was elected the third Khalifa in Rabwa. 1970 marked the year when Hazur toured West Africa. Whilst there, he felt a dire need to help the poor people around him. He devised the Nusrat Jahan scheme to tackle the problems in Africa by building hospitals and schools for the locals. By the grace of Allah, the impact of this scheme was instant, and by the end of the third Caliphate, over 20 hospitals and more than 120 schools had been built. Later that year, Hazur went on to visit Switzerland, England, Germany and Spain, laying the foundations of mosques in several of these countries. The Basharat Mosque in Spain was the first to be built in the country for more than 700 years. Of the many schemes launched by the third Khalifa, one of the most notable ones is the Ta'lim al-Qur'an scheme, launched in 1966 with the desire that there be no member of the Jamaat unable to recite the Holy Qur'an and understand its meanings. In the same year, Hazur started the Waqf-e-Arzi scheme, which required volunteers to serve the Jamaat for 2 to 6 weeks at their own expenditure. Hazur then opened the Waqf-e-Jadid office for the Atfal, encouraging them to instill the habit of sacrifice within themselves. A flame of opposition was kindled in 1974 against the community. The situation had become so grave that news of Ahmadis being arrested, injured, and even martyred was arriving on a regular basis. But the enemies did not stop there. Mosques, libraries, and mission houses were either seized or destroyed. Ahmadis all over the country were boycotted. For several months, Hazur spent his nights in prayer for the protection and well-being of his sincere followers. The eyes of the Christian world were gazed upon Ahmadiyyat in 1978, when Hazrat Mirza Nasir Ahmed delivered his speech about the breaking of the cross in London. Despite threats from different churches, Huzoor was not to be averted from presenting to the world Islam's beautiful teachings. Every moment of Huzoor's life was in accordance with the motto he chose for the Jamaat: love for all, hatred for none. Wherever he went on tour, his effort was always to bring man to love his fellow brother and to eradicate hatred completely. On the 9th of June, 1982, at the age of 73, this flag bearer of peace, Hazrat Mirza Nasir Ahmed, passed away and met with his Creator. May Allah have mercy on his soul. Ameen.
Uski surat haseen, uski sirat haseen, vash gufta dahan, wo kushada jabeen. Dars ahle wafa ko yehi de gaya pyar sab se kisi se bhi nafrat nahin.